You are to forgive yourself. Reading from Scripture, 1 John chapter 1, verse 9. If we confess our sins, He is faithful and just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Often the hardest thing for us to do after we have done something really wrong is to forgive ourselves. There is a sense of lasting condemnation for who we are and for what we have done. We tend to keep beating ourselves even long after our sins are confessed and we have been forgiven. While having a sense of remorse and guilt is necessary for a repentant heart, it is not right for us to continue staying and wallowing in that guilt and that shame even after we have confessed and asked for forgiveness from God. The Bible reminds us of the nature of God and His response to us when we repent and ask Him for forgiveness. Let's take a look at some of those. It declares in Psalm 103 that God is a compassionate and merciful God who is filled with unfailing love. It assures us that it is not the nature of God to constantly accuse us or remain angry with us forever, or even to punish us according to what our sins deserve. It also assures us that God is a forgiving and faithful God who forgives us and cleanses us from all unrighteousness that haunts or even bothers us. So if this is the way God deals with our sin, that He takes it away or He removes it as far as the east is from the west, who are we to continue to take the load and shame of our sins upon ourselves? We don't have to keep walking in self-condemnation because we have been set right in our relationship with Jesus Christ. Failing to forgive oneself of past mistakes is also really denying the work of the cross and the shed blood of Christ in our lives. When God says that we have been cleansed from our sins through the atoning work of Christ, but yet we continue to banter ourselves for our mistakes, then we are in actuality belittling what God has done for us and the high price Jesus paid to redeem us. It is like being given a precious and priceless gift. When we wholeheartedly receive and fully enjoy the gift of Christ's atoning work on the cross, the giver of the gift, who is Jesus, is glorified. But when we reject the gift or we question its power, we humiliate and we dishonor the giver. It is an expression of our love and gratitude to the Lord Jesus when we fully and wholeheartedly receive and accept the forgiveness He has given us. Let us remember that when we confess our sins, God is true and He's faithful and He's just to cleanse us from every wrongdoing and every sin we have committed. We can be bold and we can hold our head up, held up high, and we can be free of condemning ourselves. Let us pray together. Father God, we thank You for what You have done for us on the cross. And we remember that when You forgive us, You have been merciful, You have been compassionate, You have filled us with an everlasting love. Forgive us when we refuse to forgive ourselves, even after You have given us the gift of forgiveness. We pray that we will look to Your nature and the response of who You are and what You do for us when we sin. Help us to see You as a God who is compassionate and loving and forgiving. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you for tuning in to Living Supernaturally. For more resources to strengthen your spiritual walk, please visit apcwo.org.